Finally, everyone's seated. We take off. Plane heads out to San Francisco. And it was by far the most tense flight I have ever been on. I coughed once. It wasn't even a bad cough. It was just like a little tickle. I was just like, the guy opposite me was like, Ebola! Ebola! I was like, yo, dude, calm down, man. Calm down. It's just AIDS. You're safe, buddy. Everyone was so stressed. We finally land at the airport. The air hostess comes back on the PA and she goes, ladies and gentlemen, back in your seats, please. Everybody back in your seats. Unfortunately, right now we have a health and safety official that needs to come on board just to make sure that everything is A-okay due to Ebola. We're just going to make sure that everything is fine. So please stay in your seats, ladies and gentlemen. Again, apologies for the delay. She says this, and then this man comes on, a health and safety official, right? And he has with him a list of all the African passengers and a thermometer, right? And his job is to scan all the African passengers and get their temperature. So he's got the list. He walks down, ticks their names off the list, gets the temperature, gets the names, temperature, names. Finally gets to where I'm seated. Looks at me, looks at my name, looks back at me. Nah. He walks away. I'm there trying to cheer myself up. Like, chin up, Trevor. You could have Ebola. Chin up, kid. Come on. Come on. And he walks to the back of the plane. He scans the rest of the passengers. Gets to the tail. And he realizes he's now missing a name. So he looks back through the plane, can't figure out what's going on. I know it's me. I know it's me. But I'm not going to help him. He had his chance. He had a good Ebola man and he let him go. And as he panics, the air hostess comes back down the plane. And she goes, hey, what's going on? I need to get the people out of here. He goes, yeah, I know. I got a problem on the Ebola list. I can't figure out where the passenger is. And she's like, yeah, I got to get the people out. He's like, look, I know this is killing me as well, but I just got to figure out. She's like, yeah. If I don't get them out, I'm dead. I got to get the people going. He's like, yeah, I know. Just calm down. Just give me a second. And I can feel the tension building in the plane. Because some people are hearing pieces of the conversations, like broken telephone as it goes down the plane. All they're hearing is, yeah, Ebola, killing me, people. It's like, yeah, dad, everybody out of here, dad. And it's like, you feel the tension. The guy opposite me didn't even hide it. He was like, it's you, Ebola, it's you. I was like, dude, I do not have Ebola. Stop saying that. He's like, it's you, damn it, it's you. I'm busy coughing. I was like, if you don't shut up, I'll cough on you now. And he's like, what? I was like, I'll cough on He's like, what? I'll kill you. I was like, I'll kill you first. Everyone in the place starts losing. People want to leave. In the middle of the chaos, in the midst of all of this, a Middle Eastern man, he stands up and he sticks his head into the conversation being had between the air hostess and the safety official. And he goes,
excuse me, pardon me. Sorry to interrupt. I couldn't help noticing what you are talking. I just want to say, maybe you want to check. I noticed that gentleman over there was coughing a little bit. The man, he never write anything for him. I thought he was wearing a hood, something about him. I don't know, something. Just made me a little bit uncomfortable. I thought maybe you want to check. There is, you know what they say, see something, say something. Yeah.
I wanted to do the tire air prank for the longest.
Babe. Sorry, I wanted to check how much is like air, like premium air for like tires.
Premium air, what does that mean?
Because there's people here now, they've been going around the complex and they're saying they're selling like premium air. So for the car that's in the garage now, they just charge like 500 rand a tire. So premium I just swiped for that now.
You swiped?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they said it helps the car like drive better on the roads.
You swiped 2,000 for air.
But that's what I'm now asking, because they said it's premium air. It's gonna help like the car move better as well.
But I don't want to buy air.
But why?
No.
Okay, but that's why now I'm checking.
But you're checking after the fact.
But they said it's premium. So at the garage, no, listen, at the garage, it's not premium. Like they're saying at the garage, it's like it's the normal air. Like it's pointless. It doesn't last long as well.
Why are you calling me now when you could have, why are you calling me now when you could have called me before this?
Because I'm just checking with you now.
You bought air for 500 rand a tire, Ste.
To help you drive better.
Dude, I'm so shocked right now. Like, wow.
So?
So then why are you calling me then? Like, what's the point? You did it, you paid for air for 500 rand a tire.
Wow. I'm just helping you and now I'm sharing the events of the day.
Now, please tell them to take back the air and tell them you want the refund.
Okay, but how are they going to take back the air?
You literally just wasted 2K.
Okay, I'll try to get a refund.
How will you try to get a refund?
But they're still here. That's why you just said I'm going to try to get a refund. That's what I'm going to do.
But how could you agree to this, Tim?
But that's why I'm asking you.
But you already did it.
Okay, well, they're coming back now. Let me speak to them. Okay, bye.
I'm so disappointed.
Bye.
William! Come here, bro. Respect
on the name. What?
What's up, man?
What's up, bro? Oh, man. Hey man, you know I be thugging in the streets. You heard me?
Yeah.
Niggas trying to rob me on my phone, nigga.
Oh, really?
Nigga, I pulled out a pistol, nigga. Sound, everybody went down. Pop, pop. You heard? You laughing at, nigga?
Like, what is it?
They're trying to take my phone, nigga.
Yeah, nigga. What's your phone?
I'll bet next time, man. Shit. Let's bounce, man.
At first, it was panty liners, and now it's a gown. This woman is quietly moving in. Nazo, omnye ushiye I lipstick, ndiyamfonela on some, baby ulibele I lipstick yako. Did she not say akayilibalanga, uyabuya ngomso uzohamba Monday morning. Oh, spawn. Other one left slippers and tight. I shifted slippers. One day GF find tight down in Wotrop. Her delight that is mine. She said I was wet. Laugh out loud. Omunye washiya I pant. Kan kona omunye owayeshiye elak. Next thing a cell phone. I gave her wrong pant. Cho, zakhala. Once did this. Found my belongings hidden in the kitchen cupboard. Ew, girls are bad influences, aye. Bavele bashiye izinto ezi strange lab. Umuntu ashiye shot your picture. Throw them away. And just go on about your business. If she asks, say you didn't know they were hers. Lol. Shalom, my friend. Next thing uzofika sekulindile endlini. Trust me. Sras. You. Spawn.
We told you. Any expulsion from the police. No, this thing is a problem.
What is the problem?
Where are the police? Where are the police to escort you here? Where are the police?
Who escorted you?
But where are the police to escort you here? Because Mkoni, you are carrying votes of citizens here. And there is no police here to monitor this thing. There's no police here to monitor this thing. You come here, you drive alone here, there's no security here to protect this ballot. How come are you here?
Must figure bopper. Bopper, gunner, bopper. Nagro said figure my bozer. Nagro said figure my bozer. Bopper. Bopper, gunner, bopper. It's bigger than...